Let's go now to the markets and the politics. Right at our wheelhouse today, stocks are up, largely because the jobs report wasn't so hot, right? Investors have been betting that weaker than expected growth in the labor market actually lowers the odds that we'll get a rate hike in September. So we get a little bit of a rally in the market, not much really. The labor participation rate mentioned earlier, that's right around that generational low where we've been, 62.8%. Scott Martin is here, and so is Danielle DiPartino-Booth. Hello, one and all, Danielle and Scott. Scott, what did you think of today? Has it changed your thinking on anything?
I change my thinking a lot these days, Connell, but it changed one thing. Yeah, you know that already. It changed one thing for me, and I think it's the fact that there seemed to be a trade in the market until today that the Fed was on the table, definitely for December, but also possibly for September. And I think today's number at 151,000, with no change really in revisions to the prior 2 months net-net, is such a good number for this market that even rapper Chris Brown couldn't find a reason to be angry about it. I'm telling you, it's true.
A Chris Brown reference in the market segment. Only Scott could go there, Danielle. Now, I don't invite you to go in the same direction. Do you think that he's right, essentially, though, that September's off the table? Can we all agree on that now and move on to December when we're at least referring to the Fed? What do you think?
Well, you know, I've never actually thought September was on the table because I think the Fed is too political to hike rates in front of this election. But absolutely, the data right now validate they're not doing anything come September. And that's the little bit of a celebration that we're seeing today ahead of this long weekend.
Danielle, a very skeptical person. I've tried to explain to her that the Federal Reserve is an apolitical organization and doesn't get involved in that kind of thing. But apparently she's
I'm going to start. I'm going to belt out a rap of my own, buddy. Don't go there.
Wow. Actually, I might want to prompt that a little bit. So now, speaking of politics, and obviously, Scott, I'm joking around a little bit about it, but it certainly does enter things, right? What do you think the relationship is between this market, this economy, and this election right now? Have you started to, I'll say this, if this conversation was happening a week and a half ago, say, right, Scott, I think people in your position, and many have told me either privately or on the air, that I'm starting to think Hillary Clinton looks like we should start assuming she'll be the president, looking at odds and that kind of thing. But is there less of that in the Wall Street trading desks now, do you think, because the polls have tightened?
Potentially, yeah. I mean, Connell, though, I really do think Wall Street wants a Hillary presidency, and I think it's just from the main fact that she's kind of a known quantity. And I think when you look at the markets and how they've reacted to different fits and starts in the polls, the market seems at least lately to be reacting somewhat better to the Trump narrowing in the polls. But I think longer term, if you look as we go closer to November, I think Hillary, if she does pull away again, that's probably what supports the S&P here versus Trump winning at the polls in November and maybe adding that uncertainty and that volatility we haven't had all year, frankly.
Very interesting. That's a market opinion, Danielle, not necessarily a political one, by Scott, who's saying to himself, listen, this would be the status quo, essentially. We'd have rates staying low, no rate hike in September, and Hillary Clinton, the status quo candidate, winning. Do you agree that that's good for stocks? Real quick, and then we have to run.
I do think that a lot of the money that's been behind her donations has come from Wall Street firms precisely because Wall Street believes firmly that no change is a good thing going forward.
Fair enough. Up 39 right now. Have a great weekend, both of you. We are going to move on.